We're here with Whitehorse on the red carpet, Junos 2018. How are you guys doing?
We're good.
Favorite moment or event or party from the weekend so far?
I loved singing with Tara Lightfoot last night and some other women from the music scene in Canada. It was like this moment of camaraderie and obviously paying respects to the lives that were lost this year in the industry. That was a very poignant, magical moment for me personally.
You know, being the soundtrack to that kind of a tribute of the people that we've lost, does that add a level of pressure? How does that affect your performance? Is it a positive, a negative? How does it affect you?
It's absolutely positive because it's more heartfelt. And we were in that room with everyone looking at the screen and seeing the faces and the names of the people that we have lost. And then also to be standing there with other great voices, female voices, and Tara, who is just phenomenal, and that song just kills me. So it was a really beautiful moment. Personally.
It really was a beautiful performance and a beautiful moment. You know, you guys had successful careers before deciding to join up as a team. What makes you guys better as a duo than apart?
Oh, well, a lot, so many things, almost everything. You know, I have a couple of things that I do well, and Melissa has a lot of things that she does well, but we don't have the same skills. We don't write songs the same way. We don't look at lyrics the same way. We don't play instruments the same way. And where I'm lacking in almost every example of where I am lacking as an artist, she is, that's a strong suit of hers.
And so, vice versa, yeah.
It's a coincidence and a fortunate happenstance part of our relationship that, wow, look at that. I'm not great at this, but you happen to be. So.
Well, and I think we're always striving to bring out the best in each other musically, as performers, as writers, as recording artists.
Definitely.
So,
definitely.
Yeah.
Well, we love you guys. Would you like to pick a question out of our oven mitt?
I love this. That's the key. Terrifying, but.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
What is your fondest musical childhood memory involving a parent?
Well, I don't know if this qualifies as childhood, but my parents were always hugely supportive, and I started writing songs from a very young age. And when I was 15, they would drive me to the open mic night in Hamilton at La Luna, and like a little Mediterranean restaurant. And I would play my new songs that week, and they would always be there. And I met a whole community of amazing people there, people that I'm still friends with and people I still make music with. My parents are the best.
Well, I'd have to say, so my father was a guitar player living in New Orleans in the 80s. He went to Boston in 1980 or 79 and went to Berklee School of Music briefly before he relocated to New Orleans to actually play jazz. I was living with my mom and my stepdad in Winnipeg. When I was 14, my father moved back to Canada, and he moved to Winnipeg to be close to my sister and I. And I started a band with my friends in junior high school at River Heights Junior High School in Winnipeg. And we were playing the Kinks and the Who and the Stones and, you know, like the Beatles and whatever, like British Invasion rock and roll. And then we got a gig in a little bar called the Bella Vista. It's a pizza restaurant. And Armin, who owned it, said, okay, I'm going to hire you guys to play Wednesday nights. It's great. I'll pay you this much money. You're going to get some pizza. All good. We were all 15 years old. He said to us, I need somebody in the band to be of legal age to be responsible for you because you're all children. This is a licensed venue. So I hired my father to join my band, and for the next 2 years, we played Little Walter and Sonny Boy Williamson and Chuck Berry and Little Charlie and the Nightcats and B.B. King, and, you know, we played blues. And so I hadn't spent a whole lot of time with my father before that because he was living in different places, and we became friends, and we developed a relationship by the fact that I hired him to play in my band when I was 15 years old.
And your legacy of playing with family has continued. And I think it's working out very well for you guys. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your weekend. And we just love you guys so, so much. Thank you so much.